Good evening, friends. The topic that I am going to discuss today is gas chromatography, which is very important with respect to pharmaceutical industries. But before going into the details of gas chromatography, let us first understand what chromatography is. Chromatography is defined as the technical separation of a substance on the basis of its partition coefficient in two immiscible phases. The two immiscible phases are stationary phase and mobile phase. Stationary phase, which may be solid or liquid, whereas mobile phase, which may be liquid or gas. Any chromatographic technique involves four very important steps. First is adsorption or retention of a substance on the stationary phase. Second, separation of the adsorbed substances by mobile phase. Third, recovery of the separated substances by continuous flow of mobile phase, which is also called as elution. And finally, qualitative and quantitative analysis of the eluted substances. Now, what is gas chromatography? Let us understand the principle behind it. Gas chromatography was discovered by Martin and Singh, for which they got the Nobel Prize in 1952, that has made the separation of volatile mixtures easy. In gas chromatography, which is also called as GC, column is filled with adsorbent or solid support coated with non-volatile liquid. When a sample passes through a column, the constituents of sample are adsorbed on the adsorbent at different degrees. In the case of gas solid chromatography, or the constituents of samples are partitioned on liquid phase in the case of gas liquid chromatography. The mobile phase is an inert gas like nitrogen, which pushes the separated constituents out of the column and is fed to the detector. Signal from the detector are given to the recorder. Recorder plots a graph of detector response versus time. The plotted graph is known as chromatogram. Injector, column, detector are heated by housing them in thermostatic compartment so as to regulate temperature. Few microliters of samples is introduced into the injector by means of hypothermic syringe through a self-sealing silicon septum. In the injector, due to heating, sample gets vaporized. Carrier gas, which is also called as a mobile phase, pushes vapors of samples into the column. In the column, due to adsorption or of partition of constituents of sample between stationary phase and mobile phase, separation of constituents occurs. Now let us understand the instrumentation behind gas chromatography, that is GC. So this is the basic schematic representation of a typical gas chromatograph, in which we have different components such as carrier gas cylinder, second, flow controller, third, injector port, fourth, column kept in column oven, then fifth we have the detector, and sixth we have the recorder. Now let us understand each and every component in detail. First is carrier gas cylinder. Carrier gas is a mobile phase which can be nitrogen, hydrogen, helium, neon, etc. The choice of carrier gas depends on the nature of sample and detector used. Now what are the functions and features of carrier gas? First is to carry the volatile components through the column. Second, it should not react either with sample or with stationary phase, that is, it should be inert. Third, to carry the separated components to the detector. Fourth, it should be readily available in extra pure form and it should be inexpensive. Now, second is the injector. The sample is introduced into the injector by means of hypodermic syringe through a self-sealing silicon septum. The injector is heated with the help of heating coils. Injector temperature depends on the nature of the sample. Third, we have column. It is made up of stainless steel or glass with internal diameter of 0.03 to 1 mm and length of from 10 to 100 meter. The column is placed in the form of coil in a thermostatically controlled oven. Column temperature depends upon the nature of the sample. Now, there are different types of column. First is the packed column, and second we have open tubular or capillary column. Now what are packed column? Here column is filled with inert solid particles coated with liquid stationary phase. Solid supports used are diatomaceous earth, Teflon powder, etc. Stationary liquid is chosen depending on the compound to be analyzed. Second, we have open tubular or capillary column. This is prepared by coating the inner wall with stationary liquid phase. Capillary columns of internal diameter of about 0.03 to 1 mm and length up to 100 meter, made up of glass or steel, are used. there are two different types of capillary columns are available. First is wall coated open tubular column and second is support coated open tubular column. Now we have detectors. The function of detector is to sense and to measure the separated components in carrier gas flow leaving the column. The choice of detector depends on the nature of the sample and the level of analysis. Now what are the types of detectors used in gas chromatography? First is we have flame ionization detectors, which is also called as FID. Second is thermal conductivity cells, which is also called as TC cells. And third is electron capture detectors. Now there is also a component called as recorders and amplifier. Detection response produces small and weak electrical signals which are amplified by amplifier and it is fed to the recorder. Recorder plots a graph of detector response versus time. Number of peaks obtained indicates the number of components present in the sample. The area under a peak corresponds to the concentration of that component. Now let us understand what are the applications of gas chromatography. So there are many applications of gas chromatography. First is analysis of air pollutants in automobile exhaust can be done using gas chromatography. Then second is volatile substances from ambient air, biological waste and human breath can be analyzed by 300 millimeter capillary column with methyl silicon as a stationary phase. Third, flavors and aromas of flowers and foods are the result of a combination of hundreds of organic compounds in trace amounts. This can be separated by gas chromatography. Then it is also used for separation of radioactive products. Then due to its sensitivity, samples from less than a milligram to 100 gram can be detected easily by using gas chromatography. If you found my video helpful, please like my video, share my video with your friends and comment if you have any doubt regarding the session. Please subscribe my channel Salil Naik. Thank you.